Hello friends, welcome to this video on lines and angles. Today, we will discuss basic terms and definitions of lines and angles. We are surrounded by a wide variety of objects, and the formation of any object or any shape is not possible without the knowledge of lines and angles. Let's start the session with lines. As we know, lines look somewhat like this. We represent it by AB, PQ, MN, and sometimes by small letters L, M, and N also. Lines are always straight. We can say that it has no width. This sign of an arrow reflects that it can be extended infinitely in both directions. Let's take these two lines, AB and MN. In how many ways do you think we can draw them? Friends, we can draw them in two different ways. First is that both of them intersect each other, somewhat like this. Here, point C is their point of intersection. That is why they're called intersecting lines. And second, that which do not intersect each other. That is, they are parallel to each other. The length of the common perpendicular on the different points of these two parallel lines will be the same. Friends, if three or more points are situated on the same line, somewhat like this, then they are called collinear points. If they are not on the same line, they are called non-collinear points. Now friends, what will happen if we represent one end of a line by a point? Now, we will not call it a line but a ray. We call the light coming from the sun a ray because the source of origin of light is fixed. If we represent both the ends by points, then it will look somewhat like this. And now, this is a line segment. Till now, we discussed lines. Moving ahead, let's discuss angles. If two rays arise from the same endpoint, then an angle is formed. We call this common endpoint as the vertex of an angle, and the rays forming this angle are sides or arms. Friends, in the previous classes, we studied about different types of angles. Let's repeat it once. If the measure of an angle is between 0 degrees and 90 degrees, then we call it an acute angle. If the measure of an angle is exactly 90 degrees, then we call it a right angle. If the measure of an angle is more than 90 degrees, but less than 180 degrees, then we call it an obtuse angle. And if the measure of any angle is exactly 180 degrees, then we call it a straight angle. If the measure of any angle is more than 180 degrees but less than 360 degrees, then we call it a reflex angle. Friends, if the sum of any two angles is 90 degrees, then we call them complementary angles. And if the sum of any two angles is 180 degrees, then we call it supplementary angles. Let's move ahead. Friends, if two angles have a common vertex, a common arm, and their non-common arms are on different sides of the common arm, then we call such angles as adjacent angles. As you can see, in the figure, the vertex Q of both the angles is the same for angle PQS and angle SQR. And the arm QS is the common arm. And both these sides, PQ and QR, are in the opposite direction of the arm QS. That is why we can say that angle PQS and angle SQR are adjacent angles. Friends, by looking at the figure, Can you tell any relationship between the angle PQS, angle SQR and angle PQR? Note, here angle PQR is formed by joining the angle PQS and angle SQR. That is, the sum of these two angles will be equal to this, and we can write it like this. Friends, look at the figure and tell if angle MNP and angle PNO are adjacent angles. Yes, the common vertex of both the angles is the point N, and the common arm is NP. Here, the sum of these two angles is 180 degrees. In this way, a linear pair of angles is formed. If two lines intersect each other, then the vertically opposite angles are formed. Like here, the line MN is intersecting the line PQ at the point O. Here, we get two pairs of vertically opposite angles. The first pair is angle MOP and angle NOQ. Can you tell the name of the second pair? Yes, angle MOQ and angle PON is the pair of the vertically opposite angles. Friends, that's all in this session. Today, we discuss some basic terms and definitions of lines and angles. See you in the next video. Thank you. Hello friends, welcome to this video on lines and angles. In the previous video, we have already discussed the basic terms and definitions of lines and angles. Today, we will solve some questions related to these terms and definitions. Let's start with our first question. Identify the given figures by looking at them. Friends, look at the first figure. Here, on both the sides, there is a symbol of an arrow, and this shows that it can be extended further in both directions. Therefore, this is a line, line AB, and we represent it like this. Look at the second figure. Here on one end is a point, and on the other end there is a symbol of an arrow. That is, it can be extended further in only one direction. So this is a ray PQ, and we represent it like this. In the third figure, here on both the ends, there is a point. This can be part of any line, so we call it a line segment. This is line segment MN, and we can represent it like this. In this figure, an angle is given, angle ABC, and by looking at it, we can easily say that its measure is less than 90 degrees. Therefore, angle ABC is an acute angle. Friends, in the next figure also, an angle is given, angle PQR, and its measure is more than 180 degrees. Therefore, we can say that this angle is a reflex angle. Let's move ahead and see the second question. Define the given angles along with the figure. First of all, complementary angles, whose definition is like this. If the sum of two angles is 90 degrees, then we call such angles as complementary angles. For example, look at this figure. In angle XYZ, the measure of angle XYW is 30 degrees and the measure of angle WYZ is 60 degrees. On adding the two, we get 90 degrees, that is, these two angles are complementary angles. Now let's see the definition of supplementary angles. If we obtain the sum of two angles as 180 degrees, then we call such angles as supplementary angles. Look at the figure. In angle PQR, the measure of angle PQT is 60 degrees and the measure of angle TQR is 120 degrees. On adding the two, we get 180 degrees, so we can say that angle PQT and angle TQR are supplementary angles. Now let's see the definition of vertically opposite angles. When two lines intersect each other, then the vertically opposite angles are formed. Like here, line AB and line CD are intersecting each other at the point O. As a result, we get two pairs of vertically opposite angles. The first pair is angle AOC and angle BOD, and the second pair is angle AOD and angle COB. That's all in this session. Today, we saw some questions and answers related to the basic terms and definitions of lines and angles. See you in the next video. Thank you. Hello friends, welcome to this video on lines and angles. Today we will discuss some facts related to basic terms and definitions of lines and angles. Let's start with a question. State if the angles given in the figures are vertically opposite angles. No. If you are thinking that angle MNO and angle PNQ and angle MNP, angle QNO are pairs of vertically opposite angles, then you are wrong, because they are not vertically opposite angles. We get vertically opposite angles when two lines intersect each other in this way. Look at the figure carefully. Here, two lines are not intersecting each other. These are two rays, ray PN and ray NO, which arise from the point N. The position of these two rays is such that we are not getting PN as a straight line. Therefore, these angles will not be vertically opposite angles. Let's move forward to our second question. Look at the figure and state if these two angles are adjacent angles. No. In the given figure, look at these two angles carefully. These two angles have a common side, but the vertex of these two angles is different. But according to the definition of the adjacent angles, it is necessary to have a common vertex of both the angles. Therefore, these are not adjacent angles. Now let's move ahead and see another question. There is an angle with a measure more than 90 degrees. State what type of angle this is. Will this be an acute angle? No, because the measure of an acute angle is less than 90 degrees. Friends, this will also not be a right angle, because the measurement of a right angle is exactly 90 degrees. Then, is it an obtuse angle? According to the definition of an obtuse angle, if the measure of an angle is more than 90 degrees and less than 180 degrees, then it is called an obtuse angle. According to the given statement, if the measure of any angle is more than 90 degrees, then it can be an obtuse angle, but only if its measure is less than 180 degrees. But there is no such condition given in the statement, that is, its measure can be more than 180 degrees, and if this happens, then it will be a reflex angle. Friends, with this statement, we cannot specify the type of this angle. All we can say is that it will either be an obtuse or a reflex angle, because the measure of both these angles is more than 90 degrees. That's all in this session. Today, we discuss some facts related to basic terms and definitions of lines and angles. See you in the next video. Thank you.
Hello, friends. Welcome to this video on lines and angles. In the previous video, we learned about a line segment and the different types of angles. And now we are very well aware of these definitions and terms. In this video, moving a step ahead, we will discuss the pairs of angles. In the given figure, identify the ray and the line and tell their names. Here, AC is a line and BD is a ray. Friends, are angles ABD and CBD adjacent angles? Yes, we have understood this figure well. Now let's move ahead and discuss an axiom related to it. If a ray stands on a line, then the sum of the two adjacent angles thus formed is 180 degrees. If you observe the figure, there are three angles here. Can you tell the names of the three angles? Angle MOP, angle NOP and angle MON, where angle MOP and angle NOP are adjacent angles. The measure of angle MON is 180 degrees since here MON is a straight line and a straight line always makes an angle of 180 degrees. By looking at the figure, we can easily say that angle MOP plus angle NOP is equal to angle MON. Therefore, we can say that angle MOP plus angle NOP is equal to 180 degrees. And if the sum of the two adjacent angles is 180 degrees, then they form a linear pair of angles. Now, the axiom that we are going to learn is completely opposite to this axiom. If the sum of two adjacent angles is 180 degrees, then a ray stands on a line. We call this the converse of the axiom that we just learned. If we are given that angle MOP plus angle NOP is equal to 180 degrees, then we can conclude that ray OP stands on line MN. Let's move on to the next axiom. If the sum of the two adjacent angles is 180 degrees, then the non-common arms of the angles form a line. That is, if the sum of two adjacent angles is 180 degrees, then the sides which are not the common sides of these angles form a line. Friends, the two axioms that we learned together are called the linear pair axiom. Now we move on to the next theorem, which is related to the two lines. If two lines intersect each other, then the vertically opposite angles are equal. Let's convert the ray OP into a line in the same given figure. According to the theorem, we have to prove in this figure that angle MOP is equal to angle QON and angle NOP is equal to angle MOQ. So let's start. Keeping the ray OP in mind, can we say that angle MOP plus angle NOP is equal to 180 degrees? Yes, according to the linear pair axiom. Similarly, taking ON as the ray, can we say that angle NOP plus angle NOQ is equal to 180 degrees? Yes, according to the linear pair axiom. If we pay attention to both the equations, then here the right-hand side is equal, so the left-hand side will also be equal. That is, angle MOP plus angle NOP equal to angle NOP plus angle NOQ. And since here angle NOP is same on both the sides, so by cancelling it from both the sides, we can write it like this, angle MOP equal to angle NOQ. And similarly, we can also prove angle MOQ is equal to angle NOP. Keeping the ray OQ in mind, can we say that angle MOQ plus angle NOQ equal to 180 degrees? Yes, according to the linear pair axiom. Similarly, taking ON as a ray, we can say that angle NOP plus angle NOQ equal to 180 degrees. If we pay attention to both the equations, then here the right-hand side is equal, so the left-hand side will also be equal, that is, angle MOQ plus angle NOQ equal to angle NOP plus angle NOQ. And since here, angle NOQ is same on both the sides, on cancelling it from both the sides, we can write like this, angle MOQ is equal to angle NOP. So friends, in this way, we proved that the vertically opposite angles formed by the intersection of two lines are equal. With this, let's end this video. In this video, we discussed the topic pairs of angles. In the next video, we will solve some questions based on this topic. Hello friends, welcome to this video on lines and angles. In the previous video, we discussed some axioms and theorems related to lines and angles. In this video, we will solve some questions based on that topic. So let's start. In the given figure, triangle CDE is an equilateral triangle. Then prove that angle ADC is equal to angle CEB. Here, by using the linear pair axiom straight away, we can say that angle ADC plus angle CDE equals 180 degrees. And similarly, angle CED plus angle CEB equals 180 degrees. We pay attention to both the equations, then here the right hand side is equal, so the left hand side will also be equal, that is, angle ADC plus angle CDE will be equal to angle CED plus angle CEB. Now, since we are given that triangle CDE is an equilateral triangle, then all its angles will be equal to each other. Therefore, angle CDE is equal to angle CED. Hence, angle ADC is equal to angle CEB. Let's see the next question. In the given figure, lines PQ and NR are intersecting each other at point O. Angle POM plus angle QON equals 80 degrees and angle POR is 50 degrees. Then find the measure of the angle MON, angle POM and angle QOR. Friends, first of all, note how many lines are there and how many rays. From that, we will come to know how many vertically opposite angles are there and how many linear pair angles. With the help of which, we can solve this question. We are given angle POM plus angle QON equal to 80 degrees. Angle POQ is a straight line, that is, angle POQ equals 180 degrees. Or we can say that angle POM plus angle MON plus angle QON, which is equal to 180 degrees. We need to find the measure of angle MON by substituting the measure of angle POM plus angle QON. We will find the measure of angle MON. We got angle MON as 100 degrees. Now let's find the measure of angle POM. We are given angle POM plus angle QON to be equal to 80 degrees. If we get to know the measure of angle QON, then we can find the measure of angle POM. Here, lines PQ and RN are intersecting each other. That is, angle POR is equal to angle QON and similarly, angle PON is equal to angle ROQ. We don't have to find anything from angle PON and angle ROQ. But since angle QON is equal to angle POR, angle NOQ will also be 50 degrees because we are given angle POR to be equal to 50 degrees. And now, if we substitute the measure of angle QON in this equation, angle POM plus angle QON is equal to 80 degrees, then we can find the measure of angle POM, which will be somewhat like this. We got angle POM to be equal to 30 degrees. And now we have the last angle, angle QOR. Let me give some hint here and hope that you will be able to find its measure yourself. The hint is that angle QOR and angle PON are vertically opposite angles. This is a very simple and straight question. Angle AEC equals 1 by 2 angle BED and angle CED equals 60 degrees. This is given to us. We need to find the measure of angle AEC. Now let's see its solution. We know that angle AEC plus angle CED plus angle BED equals 180 degrees. Here, in place of angle AEC, we can write 1 by 2 angle BED, or in place of angle BED, we can write 2 angle AEC, and we will also write the measure of angle CED. Angle AEC plus 60 plus 2, angle AEC is equal to 180 degrees. Now, by simplifying this, we will find the measure of angle AEC. 3 times angle AEC is equal to 180 minus 60. Angle AEC equals 120 by 3. We obtained angle AEC as 40 degrees. Friends, this question can also be given to you like this, that angle AEC is to angle BED, which is equal to 1:2. And it means that if the ratio of these two angles is 1:2, that is, angle AEC by angle BED, which is equal to 1 by 2, which implies that angle AEC is equal to 1 by 2 of angle BED. So friends, a question can be given in different ways. We don't have to divert our attention from the question and the properties. With this, let's end this video. Today we solved some questions related to the pairs of angles. Thank you. Hello friends, welcome to this video on lines and angles. In the previous video, we solved some questions based on linear pair axiom and vertically opposite angles. Today we will discuss some more facts related to it and we will strengthen our knowledge on that subject. So let's start with a question. Of the given options, for which option does the figure represent two lines? Friends, you can pause the video to think about the answer. Here, when can AB and CD be lines? When the opposite angles will be vertically opposite angles? And from the given options, which option depicts the vertically opposite angles? It is the third option, which straight away states that opposite angles AEC and BED are vertically opposite angles. If you look at the second option, angle BED is 2 times angle AED, which is 120 degrees, and the sum of these two angles will be 180 degrees. Angle AED plus angle BED is equal to 180 degrees. From this, you come to know that AB is a line and ED a ray. And from the first option also, it cannot be ensured that AB and CD are lines. So friends, let's take the next question. According to the given statement, draw the figure and answer the question. You can pause the video and try to answer this question. First of all, let's draw a line AB. You can draw it in any way. But at the time of drawing the line PQ, we need to keep in mind the angle. We need to intersect line AB in such a way that angle AOP makes an angle of 70 degrees. So line PQ will be like this. Now we have to draw ray OY, which is the bisector of angle AOQ. This means ray OY divides this angle into two equal parts. And we need to find angle YOQ. Try to solve this question yourself. That's all in this session. Today, we discussed some facts related to the pairs of angles. See you in the next video. Thank you.
Hello friends. Welcome to this video on lines and angles. Today, we will discuss the properties of parallel lines and transversal. We know that when two lines are intersected by a transversal, then different types of pairs of angles are formed. For example, these are pairs of corresponding angles. and these are pairs of alternate angles. In this, we call these alternate exterior angles, and these are called alternate interior angles. And the pair of interior angles formed on one side of the transversal are called consecutive interior angles or allied angles. And sometimes these are called co-interior angles. Friends, if these two lines are parallel, then, that is, if a transversal intersects two parallel lines, then can we tell if there is any relation between the angles? Let's draw two lines, P and Q, which are parallel to each other, and a transversal N, which intersects them at points A and B respectively. Now, with the help of a protractor, let's measure the pair of corresponding angles. Here you can see that angle 1 is equal to angle 5. Angle 2 is equal to angle 6. Angle 4 is equal to angle 8. And angle 3 is equal to angle 7. Now we can say that if a transversal intersects two parallel lines, then each pair of corresponding angles are equal. This is what we call corresponding angles axiom. If a transversal intersects two lines such that a pair of corresponding angles are equal, then two lines are parallel to each other. Friends, is this statement true? Let us check this statement. Draw a line PQ and mark two points M and N on it. Construct angle PMA and angle MNC on these points in such a way that they are equal to each other. Draw the lines AB and CD by extending AM and CN respectively to the other side of PQ. These two lines are not intersecting each other. We can also measure the distance between the line AB and line CD by making a common perpendicular on them. These lengths are equal at each place. That is why we can say that these lines are parallel. Therefore, the given statement is true. And we call this converse of corresponding angles axiom. Similarly, can you tell if there is any relation between alternate interior angles formed by the intersection of two parallel lines by a transversal? Let's see. We have been given that the lines are parallel, that is, angle PCD and angle MDB are corresponding angles. So they will be equal, and angle MDB and angle NDC are also equal, as they are vertically opposite angles. From this, we can draw the conclusion that angle PCD and angle NDC will also be equal. Similarly, we can also prove that angle QCD and angle MDC to be equal to each other. Why don't you pause the video and try to prove it? Now we can write our result as a theorem in such a way that if a transversal intersects two parallel lines, then each pair of alternate interior angles is equal. Can we call two lines parallel if the alternate interior angles are equal? Let's look at the figure. Both these angles are vertically opposite angles. Therefore, angle MRQ and angle LRS will be equal. And we have been given that these two angles are equal. From these two statements, we can draw the conclusion that both these angles are equal. Friends, kindly note, these two angles are corresponding angles. Using the converse of corresponding angles axiom, we can prove that lines AB and LM are parallel lines. We can write this result also in the form of a theorem as follows. If a transversal intersects two lines such that a pair of alternate interior angles is equal, then the two lines are parallel. Friends, that's all in this session. Today we discussed the properties of parallel lines and transversal. See you in the next video. Thank you. Hello friends, welcome to this video on lines and angles. In the previous video, we discussed some properties of parallel lines and transversal. Today we will see some theorems related to the same. If a transversal intersects two parallel lines, then each pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal is supplementary. Friends, we have been given that these lines, line MN and line PQ, are parallel. And we have to prove that each pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal is supplementary. That is, the sum of angles MCD and PDC will be 180 degree, and the sum of angles NCD and QDC will also be 180 degree. Here, angle MCD and PDB are corresponding angles, so they will be equal. Angle PDC and angle PDB form a linear pair, so their sum will be 180 degree. Look at these carefully. Here, angle PDB is equal to angle MCD. So instead of angle PDB, we can write angle MCD here. Now we can say that these two angles are supplementary angles. Similarly, we can prove angle NCD and angle QDC as supplementary angles. Friends, pause the video and try to prove it yourself. Let's move ahead. In our next question, we will prove the converse of this theorem. If a transversal intersects two lines such that a pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal is supplementary, then the two lines are parallel. Let's draw a figure like this. Here, transversal AB intersects the two lines SP and RT at points C and D respectively, in such a way that the sum of these two interior angles is 180 degree. With the help of this, we have to prove that lines SP and RT are parallel lines. Now, let's look at its proof. We have been given this. Look at the figure. Angle RDB and angle RDC are forming a linear pair. So, keeping in mind the linear pair axiom, we can say that the sum of these two angles will be 180 degree. If we write these two like this, then we can say that angle SCD and angle RDB are equal. By looking at the figure, we can say that these two are corresponding angles. Therefore, using the converse of the corresponding angles axiom, we can say that these two lines are parallel. Friends, that's all in this session. Today we discussed some theorems related to properties of parallel lines and transversal. See you in the next video. Thank you. Hello friends, welcome to this video on lines and angles. In the previous video, we discussed some properties related to parallel lines and transversal. Today we will discuss some facts related to properties of parallel lines and transversal. Let's start with the statement, if a transversal intersects two parallel lines, then each pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal is complementary. Is this statement true? Friends, let's understand this statement with the help of a figure. PQ and MN are two parallel lines, and the transversal AB intersects these two lines at points C and D respectively. Interior angles formed on the same side of transversal, that is angle PCD, angle MDC and angle QCD, angle CDN, are complementary angles. And we know that angles whose sum is 90 degrees are complementary angles. Is the sum of these angles 90 degree? From the figure, we know that their sum is more than 90 degrees. And to prove this, we can use this theorem. If a transversal intersects two parallel lines, then each pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary. That is, the sum of these two angles is not 90 degree, but 180 degree. Therefore, this statement is false. Let's move ahead and look at a question. With the help of information given in the figure, choose the correct option. Friends, see the figure carefully. The measure of this angle is 70 degree and the measure of this angle is 110 degree. These two angles are vertically opposite angles, so they will be 110 degrees. And these two angles form a linear pair, so we can write them like this. We get the measure of X as 110 degree. Be careful, here the measure of both X and Y is same. And using converse of the corresponding angles axiom, we can say that these two lines are parallel. Therefore, option 1 is correct. Friends, that's all in this session. Today we discussed some facts related to properties of parallel lines and transversal. See you in the next video. Thank you. Hello friends, welcome to this video on lines and angles. In the previous video, we discussed some properties of parallel lines and transversal. Today, we will discuss the properties of lines parallel to the same line. Friends, let's start with a question. If a line is parallel to two lines, that is, line P is parallel to line Q and the line P is also parallel to line R, then will lines Q and R also be parallel? Come, let's take a look. In the previous video, we saw when a pair of corresponding angles are equal, the lines are parallel. So let's draw a transversal line S here. Here, lines P and Q are parallel. Therefore, using the corresponding angles axiom, we can say that angle 1 and angle 2 will be equal. And here, lines P and R are also parallel. Therefore, angle 1 and angle 3 will be equal. Looking at both the statements, we can say that angle 2 and angle 3 will also be equal. Friends, note that these are corresponding angles drawn by the transversal S with the lines Q and R. Here, using the converse of the corresponding angles axiom, we can say that these two lines, that is, line Q and line R, will also be parallel. We can write this result in the form of a theorem as lines that are parallel to the same line are parallel to each other. Can this rule also be applied to more than two lines? Yes. If lines are given such that line A is parallel to line B, line A is parallel to line C, and line A is also parallel to line D, then all these lines will be parallel to each other. You can pause the video and try to prove it. Friends, see this figure. Here lines AB and lines MN are parallel. Can you find the measure of angle OPC? How? Yes, we can draw a line SP through point P, which is parallel to line AB. Now look at the figure. Angle OPC is made up of angle CPS and angle SPO. We can write it like this. Here, line AB is parallel to line SP. So the alternate angles BCP and CPS formed here will be equal. And we are given that the measure of angle BCP is 40 degrees. So the measure of angle CPS will also be 40 degrees. Line AB is parallel to line SP. And we are given that the line AB is also parallel to line MN. So, lines SP and MN will also be parallel, because lines parallel to the same line are parallel to each other. Angle MOP and angle OPS are interior angles formed on the same side of the transversal. So, their sum will be 180 degrees. We are given the measure of angle MOP as 140 degrees. By placing its value here, we can calculate the value of angle OPS. We get the value of angle OPS as 40 degrees. Now by placing the value of both these angles in equation 1, we can find the value of angle OPC. Here we can get the value of angle OPC as 80 degrees. That's all in this session. Today we discussed some properties of lines parallel to the same line. See you in the next video. Thank you. Hello friends, welcome to this video on lines and angles. In the previous video, we discussed the properties of lines parallel to the same line. Today we will solve some questions related to the same. Let's start with our first question. If a transversal intersects two lines such that the bisectors of a pair of corresponding angles are parallel, then prove that the two lines are parallel. Friends, let's draw a figure with the help of the statement. Transversal CD intersects line RQ and line TS at points A and B respectively. Ray AM is the bisector of angle RAB and ray BN is the bisector of angle TBD. According to the statement, ray AM and ray BN are parallel, and we have to prove that lines RQ and TS are parallel. Ray AM is the bisector of angle RAB. That is, we can write angle MAB like this, and similarly, we can write angle NBD like this, as ray BN is the bisector of angle TBD. Ray AM and ray BN are parallel and CD is a transversal. Here, using the corresponding angles axiom, we can say that angle MAB and angle NBD will be equal. If in equation 3 we substitute the values of equation 1 and 2, then we can write them like this. Now angles RAB and TBD are equal. But these are corresponding angles made by transversal CD with lines RQ and TS, and they are equal. Therefore, using converse of the corresponding angles axiom, we can say that lines RQ and TS are parallel. Let's move to our next question. In the figure, line AB is parallel to line CD and line CD is parallel to line EF. If angle BPQ equals to 110 degree, then find the values of X and Y, and then show that line AB, line CD and line EF are parallel to each other. We are given that line AB is parallel to line CD. Therefore, according to corresponding angles axiom, angle BPQ and angle DQR will be equal, and the measure of angle BPQ is 110 degree. Therefore, angle DQR will also be 110 degree. That is, the value of X is found to be 110 degree. Line CD is parallel to line EF. According to corresponding angles axiom, angle DQR and angle FRN will be equal. And we saw that the measure of angle DQR is 110 degree. Therefore, the measure of angle FRN will also be 110 degree. That is, we can say that Y is equal to 110 degree. Note here, angle BPQ is equal to angle FRN. And these are corresponding angles. Therefore, keeping in mind the converse of corresponding angles axiom, we can also say that line AB and line EF are parallel to each other. We are given that line AB is parallel to line CD and line CD is parallel to line EF. Lines that are parallel to the same line are parallel to each other. We can use this theorem here as well and say that these lines are parallel to each other. Let's move ahead and see one more question. In the figure, if line XY and CS are parallel, angle XPT equals to 60 degrees and angle YPR equals to 60 degrees, then find the measure of angles A, B, M and N. Friends, look at the figure carefully. Angle XPT and angle PTR are alternate angles, so both of them will be equal. We are given that the measure of angle XPT is 60 degrees. So, the measure of angle PTR or angle A will also be 60 degrees. Angle XPT, angle TPR and angle YPR, the sum of these three angles is 180 degrees, as they are angles around a straight line. Here we know that the value of angle XPT and angle YPR. By solving in this way, we can find the value of B. Angle YPR and angle PRS are interior angles on the same side of the transversal, so they are supplementary angles. Therefore, their sum will be 180 degrees.
We know that the value of angle YPR is 60 degrees and angle PRS is M.
By writing in this way, we can find the value of M. We get M as 120 degrees. Look at the figure carefully. Angle QPY and angle PTR are corresponding angles. That is, angle A and N are corresponding angles. And the measure of A is 60 degrees. Therefore, N will also be 60 degrees. Friends, that's all in this session. Today we solved some questions related to properties of lines parallel to the same line. See you in the next video. Thank you. Hello friends, welcome to this video on lines and angles. Today we will discuss some facts related to lines parallel to the same line. Let's start with a question. In the given figure, line P is parallel to these three lines. Can you tell which of the below given options is correct? Look at the first option. Are these lines also parallel? We are given that line P is parallel to these three lines. If we use this theorem here, that lines that are parallel to the same line are parallel to each other, then we can say that these lines are also parallel. That is, this option is correct. Is the second option also correct? Here it is given that these angles are equal. Friends, these lines are parallel to each other. Therefore, these angles will be corresponding angles. And we know that corresponding angles are equal. So this option is also correct. Now look at the third option. Here these angles are equal to each other. Look at the figure carefully. These angles are pairs of alternate angles. And the pair of alternate angles are equal to each other. Therefore, this option is also correct. Now look at the fourth and the last option. Here it is given that the sum of these angles is 180 degrees. By looking at the figure, we can see that these angles are interior angles formed on the same side of the transversal. We have learned that the sum of these angles is 180 degrees. Therefore, this option is also correct. By looking at all these results, we can say that the number of parallel lines do not affect their properties.
All those properties that apply to two parallel lines applies to them too.
That's all in this session. Today we discussed some facts related to lines parallel to the same line. See you in the next video. Thank you. Hello friends. Welcome to this video on lines and angles. In the previous session, we learnt about lines parallel to the same line. In today's video, we will discuss angle sum property of a triangle and theorem of exterior angle of a triangle. We will prove two theorems using the properties of parallel lines. So let's start with the first theorem. The sum of all the angles of any triangle is 180 degrees. Friends, you have learned this statement before, but today we will prove it. Suppose a triangle ABC is given, whose angles are angle A, angle B and angle C. We have to prove that angle A plus angle B plus angle C equals 180 degrees. Or we can also write it as angle BAC plus angle ABC plus angle ACB equals 180 degrees. Just keep in mind that the alphabet of the angle that you are referring to is in the middle. Now let's draw a line parallel to any one side of this triangle. Let's draw a line parallel to side BC in such a way
that it passes through the third vertex of this triangle.
Let's call this line PQ. Friends, what will be the value of angle PAB plus angle BAC plus angle QAC? The sum of these three angles will be 180 degrees because they are angles formed on a straight line. let us call it equation 1. And because line PQ and line segment BC are parallel, so now we will use the properties of transversal. Therefore, angle PAB is equal to angle ABC, and angle QAC is equal to angle ACB,
because these are pairs of alternate interior angles.
Equation 2. Now in equation 1, we can write angle ABC instead of angle PAB, and angle ACB instead of angle QAC. So equation 1 will be angle ABC plus angle BAC plus angle ACB equals 180 degrees. So friends, thus the theorem is proved. Let us now move to the second theorem.
This theorem states that
if one side of a triangle is extended, then the exterior angle so formed is equal to the sum of the two interior opposite angles. Friends, this is also called the theorem of exterior angle of a triangle. So let's take triangle ABC again and extend the side BC slightly to the point D. We have to prove that the exterior angle ACD is equal to angle BAC plus angle ABC. Friends, this is quite easy. Here BCD is a line and angle ACB and angle ACD are linear pair angles. That is, we can say that angle ACB plus angle ACD equals 180 degrees. Let's call this equation 1. And as we just learned, the sum of the three angles of a triangle is 180 degrees, which means angle BAC plus angle ABC plus angle ACB will be equal to 180 degrees. Let's call this equation 2. Now if we look at equations 1 and 2, the RHS of both the equations are equal. Therefore, the LHS of both the equations will also be equal. We can also write it like this. Angle ACB plus angle ACD equals angle BAC plus angle ABC plus angle ACB. Let's call this equation 3. Angle ACB is on both sides of this equation. We can cut it from both sides and write like this. Angle ACD equals angle BAC plus angle ABC. And this is what we had to prove. So friends, the second theorem also ends here. Let's end this video here. Today, we studied the angle sum property of a triangle and theorem of exterior angle of a triangle. In the next video, we will solve some questions based on these methods. Thank you. Hello friends, welcome to this video on lines and angles. In the previous video, we learned about the angle sum property of a triangle and theorem of exterior angle of a triangle. Today we will solve some questions related to these theorems. So let's start with the first question. In the given triangle, side CA is further extended to point E and side BC is extended to point D. If angle EAB equals 130 degrees and angle ACD equals 100 degrees, then find the value of angle ABC. Let us first look at the angles for which the values are given. Angle EAB equals 130 degrees and angle ACD equals 100 degrees. We have to find the value of angle ABC. And this is the solution. First of all, angle EAB plus angle BAC will be equal to 180 degrees because it is a linear pair. Now if we keep the value of angle EAB, then it will be 130 degrees plus angle BAC, which equals 180 degrees. Thus, angle BAC will be equal to 180 degrees minus 130 degrees, which is equal to 50 degrees. Let's name it as equation 1. Similarly, we can find angle ACB. Angle ACB plus angle ACD equals 180 degrees because it is a linear pair. Now we'll put the value of angle ACD in it. We get the value of angle ACB as 80 degrees. Let's name it as equation 2. And angle ABC plus angle ACB plus angle BAC is equal to 180 degrees according to the angle sum property of a triangle. Now if we keep the values of equation 1 and equation 2 in it, we will get angle ABC equals 50 degrees. Thus, the first question is solved. Now let's move to the second question. Identify whether triangle POQ in the given figure is an equilateral triangle or not. So let's write the given values first. Angle MNO equals 70 degrees. Angle NMO equals 50 degrees. And angle OPQ equals 60 degrees. We have to find out whether triangle POQ is an equilateral triangle or not. Friends, to find this out, we will find the values of all the angles of the triangle and see if all the angles are 60 degrees or not. In the triangle MNO, angle NMO plus angle MNO plus angle MON will be equal to 180 degrees, according to angle sum property of a triangle. According to the given values, this will become 50 degrees plus 70 degrees plus angle MON equals 180 degrees. We will get angle MON equals 60 degrees. Now, since angle MON and angle POQ are vertically opposite angles, angle MON will be equal congruent to angle POQ. That is, angle POQ will also be equal to 60 degrees. And since angle POQ, angle OPQ and angle PQO are angles of the same triangle, therefore angle POQ plus angle OPQ plus angle PQO equals 180 degrees. Here we are given the value of angle OPQ and we have also found the value of angle POQ. Putting both the values in this equation, we get angle PQO equals 60 degrees. And now we can see that all the angles of the triangle POQ are 60 degrees. That is, this triangle is an equilateral triangle. With this, let's move to the last question of this session. In the given figure, OQ is parallel to RS. Angle QRS is equal to 30 degrees and side PT is perpendicular to the side QR. Then find the value of angle OPT. Let's write the given values and what we have to find. Now let's see its solution. Since OQ is parallel to RS, therefore angle QRS will be congruent to angle PQR, or we can say that since angle PQT is an alternate angle, therefore angle QRS equals angle PQT equals 30 degrees. And now if we use the theorem of exterior angle of a triangle, then we can say that angle OPT equals angle PTQ plus angle PQT. And keeping the value of all the angles, we get angle OPT equals 90 plus 30 equal to 120 degrees. And this is our final answer. Angle OPT equals to 120 degrees. Friends, with this, let's end this video. Today we solved some questions related to angle sum property of a triangle and theorem of exterior angle of a triangle. In the next video, we will discuss some facts based on these topics. Thank you. Hello friends, welcome to this video on lines and angles. In the previous video, we solved some questions related to angle sum property of a triangle and exterior angle property of a triangle. Today we will discuss some more facts related to the same. In the given figure, side BC is the angle bisector of angle ABD. Angle ABC is equal to X degrees. And angle BDC is equal to Y degrees. Now, can you tell what kind of a triangle is triangle BCD? You can pause the video and then solve this question. Friends, as angle ABC is X degrees, so angle CBD will also be X degrees, because side BC is the angle bisector of angle ABD. Angle ABC is equal to angle BCD as they are alternate angles. Thus, angle BCD is also an angle of X degrees. And angle BCD is equal to angle CBD is equals to X degrees. That is, triangle BCD is an isosceles triangle. Correct? Friends, there is an error in this answer. We said that angle ABC is equal to angle BCD because they are alternate angles. But have we been given that the side AB and side CD are parallel sides? No. Unless we are given that the sides are parallel,
We cannot say that angle BCD and angle CBD are alternate angles and will be equal.
We can find the value of angle BCD by using the angle sum property of a triangle. Pause the video and try to solve it yourself and see if the given triangle is a scalene triangle or not. That's all in this session. Today we discussed some facts related to angle sum property of a triangle. See you in the next video. Thank you.